Before proceeding, please make sure to subscribe and turn on the bell icon for upcoming videos. You can always support my work with your likes, comments, and shares, and you can join me on Facebook and Instagram through the links given at the description box. Maxilla is an irregularly shaped paired bone and is formed by the union of two maxillary bones at the intermaxillary suture. It forms the dominant portion of the face. On this lateral view, the two main parts maxilla has is the body and the processes. The body occupies the maxillary sinus, viewed here from an internal view of a single maxillary bone. The maxillary sinus is pea-sized at birth. It gradually increases in size with increasing age. The processes each maxilla has are the frontal, the zygomatic, the alveolar, and the palatine process. The frontal process articulates with the frontal bone, the zygomatic process unites with the zygomatic bone, the alveolar process includes tooth sockets of upper teeth, and finally the palatine process joins with the palatine bone and forms the anterior two-thirds of the palate. Let's now look at the development of the maxilla. The development of the maxilla arises from the first pharyngeal arch called the mandibular arch. The mandibular arch is one of the five pairs of pharyngeal arches present at the neck region of the embryo. Out of these five arches, the first arch, named the mandibular arch, soon gives off a division by the end of week 4. This very first division of the mandibular arch is called the maxillary prominence. The maxillary prominence will eventually give rise to the maxillary bone through the process of intramembranous bone formation. No arch cartilage is associated with the formation of the maxillary bone. The center of ossification from which the bone formation begins actually has a close association with the cartilage of the nasal capsule. The center of ossification appears in the angle between the infraorbital and the anterior superior alveolar nerves. Both of these nerves are divisions of maxillary branch of fifth cranial nerve or trigeminal nerve. The maxillary teeth are innervated by three superior alveolar nerve branches. These are the anterior superior, the middle superior, and the posterior superior alveolar nerves. From the center of ossification, the bone formation spreads in so many directions to form the complex bone of maxilla. Ossification spreads posteriorly below the orbit and towards the developing zygoma. Anteriorly, it spreads towards the future incisor teeth, superiorly to form the frontal process, and then it also spreads towards the palatine process to form the hard palate and then towards the main body of the maxilla. Later on, a secondary cartilage contributes to the development of the maxilla. This secondary cartilage is present at the zygomatic process of the maxilla, and it persists for a short time and adds considerably to the development of the maxilla. If you think this video was really helpful, please give a thumbs up and share this video ahead. Please subscribe to the channel and turn on the bell icon to get notified on each upcoming video. And in case if you have got any questions about this video or any other video, you can write it down in the comment section below. Thank you for watching.